I'm going to talk about the solution of KZN using the theory of Picard ratio of non-commutative differential equation. I already presented this theory not next last year, but before the year before. So it is a direct application of this theory. Okay. So the goal is to obtain the recursive solution for KZn. Then of course, Kreek-Ahrens 4, because KZ3 is already known nowadays. The complete solution and some connected problem are presented last year. So I try after KZ3, I try to go to KZ4 and so on. Okay. Well, for that, I will remind some algebraic tool and some Picard ratio theory related on this problem. Okay. So for that all, to adapt our theory, we first need to consider the ring of coefficients. The ring coefficient this time is the ring of holomorphic function, over the universal covering of coefficient space, this set, okay? And we also need to introduce the encoding alphabet. This alphabet, this time, is the doubly indexes, and the index ij satisfies this triangular condition. Okay. The KZn equation. KZn equation is a non-commutative differential equation, first order non-differential equation. It is for sum over I less than j, less or equal to n, dij over 2 I pi, the differential of logarithm zi minus zj. Okay? So this kind of differential equation, well, we can apply the iterative method which will be conversion here with the ultrametric topology over this ring of formal power series. The trivial case is a case in which n equal to 2, the solution is completely in the closed form. Here, the closed form is the sense of Liouville, meaning that we use just the elementary function, in the sense of Liouville, that means the exponential and the logarithm. Okay? According to Trinfeld says that the KZn is completely integrable. If this condition is satisfied, it follows that this condition applies the following quadratic relation amongst Tij. It looks like to very nearby to the infinitesimal breadth relation. This relation generates some lead. Lead ideal, quotiented to this ideal, the solution. Now, if integrable, then the solution will be in this quotient. Okay, so recall some facts from non-commutative non-commutative power series. Here, you just consider the differential ring, this differential ring of holomorphic function on the subtly connected manifold. Okay. This equipped the partial diffraction operator, dn, and the exterior diffraction satisfies this relation. Okay. Consider the subring of A, this C of A. We can consider the path, integration path. That means the parametrized curve from zero, 1 to, sorry, EV, calligraphic V, not U. So that gamma 0 is the starting point and gamma 1 is an end point. Okay? And we consider the differential form. This differential form omega ij is a exact form. This is the differential exact form. Okay. For example, using the C ij is a logarithm. We can consider the subdiffraction ring. Here we can take all the derivation of dij and we get a polynomial on this rational function. So that is the polynomial on some kind of rational function on several variables. And this is a subdifferential ring of A, of course. This I will use systematically this kind of ring of coefficient is our problem here. Okay? And the classic notation concerning formal power series here and some lexicographic ordering over Tn. I must precise which kind of lexicographic ordering I will use in this kind of problem, of course. Now, let consider the intermediate alphabet, the capital Tk, just the letter, letter indexes belong to 1 to k minus 1. This intermediate k starts, of course, from 2 and n. So that for any k calligraphic n, k, tk is partitioned on two parts, capital K and calligraphic tk minus 1, like that. Okay? So, for example, this partition k is done because I need later to give a recursive. Recursive algorithm to compute the Kz k using Kz k minus 1, of course. That imposed is our choice of strategy of to resolve our problem. Okay. Be careful the cardinality of these two set change when we change when n is greater than 4, of course. We can see that, okay? N is 4. And in the case of T3, is the adverse can happen, okay? We can consider now the power series with coefficient in A. In A, A is the ring of holomorphic function, equipped the differential form, this partial differential form, by taking coefficient by coefficient. The same of that, okay? And we have now the diffusion ring of Forman power series. Now, let's the main tool of our algorithm is based in on the pair of base in duality. The pair of base in duality is a Lyndon Poincaré Birkwood basis of the enveloping algebra freely generated by TN, and its dual basis SL. For example, in the case of KZ3, this ordering suffice to solve our problem in KZ3 with this ordering, okay? And by induction, we can prove exactly that this term for E1 or 2, this term are Lindenworth, and the P indexes by this Lindenworth are in the form. Lie bracket, iterated Lie bracket, of course. And the dual basis of P are exactly T1, 2, K, T, I, 3. Okay. Sorry, it's blocked again. Okay. Okay, the diagonal series is just now with our problem today of this time, the diagonal series, I will fix some ordering over Tn such that I can get this decreasing ordering. Okay, of this one. So the quick one is on the left and the smallest is on the right. Okay, for that, the total ordering must I choose is this way, okay, and on we can fix also this ordering between capital T intermediate alphabet to get this ordering between the set of Lindenworth, and here so we can expect this ordering previously determined this one. Okay, and the intermediate, and using the Pratt relation, this will be redux, of course. Okay, and the second second string that for the, this kind of if we give two letters T less than X, these are Lindenworth with this ordering, of course. And the Linden Poincaré Birkwood basis are this Lie bracket T X. And the dual basis of this one now is in this form. It's very simple. Okay? So this give some simplification because the Pratt-like relation, this line can help to simplify this packet, of course. We will see that in example, of course. Okay, and so I need some notation when I work on the with relation, Pratt-like relation. I will use this notation, double the notation I previously introduced. Okay, And using the Lazar elimination, we can say that the ideal of Li ideal generated by this monomial, Li monomials, and the Poincaré Birkhoff associated to this Li ideal is in this form. Okay. And I have said previously, now the Linden Poincaré Birkhoff basis is can be computed for example the of order one, order two. Now they just reduce to this Sky polynomial, and after that we can iterate it, take the Li packet iteratively, of course. Okay. Now let's see some differential part of our problem. The iterated integrand associated to the one differential form omega ij previously introduced is just like it's just be this type type integrands respected to the ordering. We have this one, okay? And the chain series is just the non-commutative chain series of iterated integrals, okay? And we use chain lemma that say that the iterated integral of shuffle of UV is a product of two iterated integrals, and we can deduce easily that the iterated integrand associated to the letter tk is just the primitive of t, this primitive over factorial k. And so the iterated integrand associated to t star, the clean star of t, is this exponential. That explains why in the k of kz2, the solution is in exactly in this form. Now let us give this lemma. This just rephrase of the basic triangular theorem given 2 years ago. This says that this map for ADU W associated to this integral, there are some equivalent to say that this iterated integral are linearly independent over C. In other case, today is C0 exactly introduced previously. The iterated integral of Lindenworth are exactly independent over C. So things letter are Lindenworth, we can deduce that the primitive associated to letter T are exactly independent over C, or equivalently to say that the primitive associated to letter T and to the neutral element are linearly free over C. Okay, so what happened in the case previously introduced is the case C0. I say that all the elements of this ring are polynomial and their primitives are logarithms. They are transcendent. So what explains why in the case, in the study of polylogarithm or hypergeometric function, this kind of situation could happen? Well, we have the, it suffices to have the linear independent of the primitive associated to letter over C0 to have all the previous facts. Okay. The non-commutative differential equation, this is this equation. This equation can be considered as a universal differential equation because if we specialize each letter matrices or vector field, we obtain respectively the linear differential equation or non-linear differential equation. And the here, the differential is we just say that there are some differential form not precise, okay? Not like I said. And the chain series by the Ri theorem, the chain series is group-like, so it can be factorized using Lindenworth this way. Okay, and their logarithms are primitive, and we can get explicitly the expression of P. I forget to give P1 here. P1 is some Lie series. I forget to give here. Sorry. I will precise next. Okay. And this chain series is exponential bounded. That means that each coefficient are iterated integral. They are bounded by C constant. Mu is some morphism of monism over factorial of length of W. Okay. If follows that the differential Galois group of the group-like solution of this equation is the Hausdorff group. And we can take the division by Picard ratio extension of this equation. This equation is the extension from this ring of coefficient by the chain series, because that this solution is when know which one. Now let us see the algorithm how to compute solution recursively. The work of Lévi-Sage, I learned the first time 20 years ago by Pierre Cartier and Pierre Lochard. I don't know why he says that, Lévi-Sage, but I can understand that is some recursivity. So let's see in the case of KZ3. In the KZ3, the multiplier is this sum of differential form multiplied by this letter. This letter are, remember that they are non-commutative, okay? And the solution of this differential equation, KZ3, can be computed by this iterative schema. It's just a Picard iterative schema. This gives, of course, the chain series. So, no. But we can also compute by this way that this schema gives also the solution of this equation, KZ3. This KZ3. We start with exponential of t12 over d2 logarithm, and after that, iteratively, we integrate. Okay, that means that we integrate first with this part. After that, iteratively, we can compute by completing this part. It corresponds to the second part of this operator. This is a classical iterative schema in functional expansion. They say that they are Volterra expansion. Volterra expansion. And so explicitly, this schema gives the solution in the form V0, G. V0, we already see that, this one, V0, okay? And G is this infinite sum, indexes by word over only t13 and t23 of iterated integral. Be careful. Here, the letters are modified by this automorphism of Lie algebra. This is automorphism, Lie algebra, okay? And I said previously, this Lie iterated packet is exactly this element of Li Poincaré Birkhoff. So we can take the dual. And if phi is this automorphism of Li Ingres, the adjoint is given by this form, because we can check replace here. And we can compute the adjoint of phi, of course. Okay? And now the solution of KZ3 is V0, G, and G now satisfies this differential equation. Now the letter T13 and T23 are modified by this automorphism. And so if we take in the affine plane, Z1 minus Z2 equal 1, we get logarithm equal 0 and then identity at this time with some change variable, we get here the multiplication applicator in the case of polylogarithm, of course. So the solution of this equation is the non-computational interpreting of polylogarithm, noted in L, and satisfies the asymptotic solution. To give the exact solution, we need to introduce this homomorphic substitution, the GI map Z3 to this quotient, okay? And so the L of this quotient is a particular solution of KZ3 in this plan. Okay? And so we can multiply now by this group-like series. This is a constant group-like series because the variable is here is Z3, but here are constant. So it is also the solution of KZ3, and this solution, of course, is already suggested by Trinfen. Okay, so we will apply this kind of techniques, but this time it's more complicated because the ordering lexical, because the lexical ordering, graphic ordering we have chosen. Okay, let us see also in the case of KZ3, the non-computational geometric series of polylogarithm. Here the polylogarithm are defined as a character one here, and for x0 and x1 is just two logarithms, and for any Lindel word in this form is just the iterated integral with omega 0 omega 1 is this differential form. And we know that the L series is group-like by Friedrich criterion. It is group-like and it can be factorized by using Lindel words. And in particular, it satisfies these two asymptotic conditions given by Trinfen, of course. And so, sorry?
The first is on the left. Phi KZ is on the left.
Not it's there. Okay, it's there. Okay, and that is a phi KZ. You see that is a sequence with some change of variables. Of course, that are phi KZ. Is phi KZ is now is taking is exactly in this form without conversion local coordinate. Of course. Okay, all are conversion in this Frighten. So for the KZN, we need to give some solution and the asymptotic condition. Okay, for KZN, we will see that later. Now let's back to the general case. General case, we give here the iterated gamma this iterative gamma using the starting point. The starting point is this shuffle of exponential primitive of related to t and t. That is this exchangeable series. Okay. And we can prove that V0 satisfies the partial equation, this one, partial equation. Here n is fixed, so n minus n, is fixed, k move from 1 to n minus 1. And explicitly, we can say that this iterative integral is this form, here k w, annexes by w, the w is this form, this word. Okay, they are called in the functional expansion, they call that Volterra kernel. The Volterra kernel multiplied by this can be expanded using the automorphism, Lie automorphism, and we are using the Taylor expansion. You can write by this form, okay? And of course, by this form, we can reduce using the Effingham Pratt-like relation, of course. And after the done by this reduction, this kernel can be factorized quantitatively by this word, because W is the word T E1, G1 to T E M, G M, okay? And the automorphism of Lie algebra is such that is identity on Tn, capital Tn, and over T calligraphic n minus 1 map the letter Tig to this group-like element, okay? Of course, we can extend it this automorphism as a comorphism of a completed of polynomials, such that restricted on and after that we take the action of this automorphism the comorphism. The action of this comorphism restricted in this set shuffle is automorphism of the shuffle algebra. And we have this inclusion, just the inclusion. And now we can conclude that the solution of KZN without I two Pi, of course, that this differential equation admits the solution V0 G, and G is a solution of the differential equation of order n minus 1, but the multiplier here is modified by the Lie automorphism, this one. Okay, and by duality, we can say that G is the chain series of this iterative integral. Here, the iterative before to take iterative integral, we make we map each word by the action, of course. And of course, we can here again they are G is a group Lie, and we can factorize by this form. And we can learn from geometry differential that that exists as a sum G so that acts by pullback over the differential form. So the multiplier, this multiplier, can be imaged by the pullback by G, by this. Okay, so. Now, go to the KZN, KZN with omega ij, ij zij equal d of logarithm zi minus zi. And make, of course, this change of variable to introduce again 2i pi. We can say that the non-convoluted differential equation is in the form fx multiplied by j, and the f satisfies this asymptotic condition and satisfies this partial differential equation. Okay. A partial equation is that it's nothing else as the multiplier of the hyperlogarithm. Hyperlogarithm in the case of Lapodin-Lewinsky hyperlogarithm. Okay? And the J satisfies this differential equation of order n minus 1 and the multiplier is modified by the automorphism phi. So, and here again, when we fix in the intersection of this hyperplane, okay, and this multiplier coincides exactly to the multiplier m minus 1 because this gives this automorphism R identity, we map Tij to Tij, of course.
Tij is Zi minus Zn minus 1?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, this one.
And why?
Yeah, this equal 1, and logarithm of 1 is 0, 0, exponential 0 is 1, so this is identity.
Why do you have two indices in P?
In P, Pj? Oh, sorry, in N. I'm sorry.
Okay.
N. N. Okay. I'm sorry for the mistake here. Okay. And conversely, if F satisfies this partial equation, this one, partial equation, and J satisfies the non-commutative differential equation of order n minus 1 with this modification, then the product of two satisfies again the differential equation of order n, of course. Okay. Let us see in the case of KZ4. We get that. We get here the automorphism of Lie and Capra, and it's adjoint. Okay, and that adjoint. And when Z4 moves to Z3, in this case, moves to Z3, V0 is again this exponential. And J satisfies this non-commutative differential equation, this one. Okay, this one. And considering P14, this intersection, in this intersection, we have all of that R equals zero and phi identity. So I say previously, V zero is one and M3 T bullet four exactly coincide with V2. So we can say that for compute the solution of KZ4, we need to, we can compute the particular solution in this intersection, the intersection of hyperplane. Okay, the solution, use the solution of KZ3, of course. Okay. And so the we can now, as in the case of polylogarithm, introduce the character. Type one is identity, and the primitive for the each letter, so just a primitive, and for any Lindenworth in this form, the iterated integral. and we consider the non-continuity series of this function, we can say that because they are logarithms. So all primitives related to t are linearly independent over C0, and f now is unique solution of this non-continuity differential equation. Okay. And f satisfies this asymptotic condition. This asymptotic condition. Zi minus 1, z minus 1. And gi here satisfies the differential equation. This one. Okay. And we know that this. We can prove because they are iterated integral, and by Friedrich criterion, they are one again, they are multiply, and so we can factorize by Lindenworth, and the logarithm of f is given by this expansion here. I don't forget to give the expression of the Lie polynomial, this expression P1. So, thank you very much. I like this song.
Thank you very much. And now we have time for questions and discussion.
Something is any some result other just rewriting. So you have just configuration space of the n plus one point, then you consider
yes,
the bar from to n, and then there is a fiber which you denote with this t1 and tn, and then there is connection using the biological of connection, and then you just rewrite solution in the form with respect to base and the fiber. So is anything more than that?
So would you, I don't master of the question of a connection, but the solution, this form of the solution, as is the case of polygon series L, now you can get the series F now exactly in the same form, factorized by that. And we just here, we use elementary function exponential of logarithm here. Iterated. On the here and fs is this iterated integral is not exactly elementary function, but it is in the extension of Liouville by integration.
My question, so you can understand here is the logic of connection on the configuration space of n plus one point.
Yeah.
And then you can you have a map from n plus one point to n point.
Yeah.
And with the fiber which you denoted with cardinal t1, t1n, t2n, and so on. And so therefore, so what you consider solution, which is just with respect. So you just make solution on the configuration space of n plus one point. Just as the product
yes.
configuration space of the
yes.
endpoint and the fiber. Is anything more than that, or in your talk, or it's only about that?
That is an asymptotic condition. Say that is if the z1 move to z I minus 1, this have this asymptotic exponential of t I minus 1. I logarithm of this one and some of the solution. Yes. I don't see the fiber here. What? Do you remember in the case of polylogarithm? polylogarithm, this one, and this is asymptotic here condition.
Yeah, but if you will go to your main theorem.
Yeah. The main theorem, yes, that is one, yes.
Yeah, so this is just what's written, that this is exactly written that that dnf equal nn minus f, it means that you consider the solution in the fiber, and then...
Yeah, that is in this corollary, it's just to give the exact form as for the L series, this form. Now you have the form of the solution is this form. And this form, you can check this form satisfy exactly this asymptotic condition. Well, the solution is this one.
May I suggest that this question will be discussed later? And I have a small question.
Yes.
Can you imagine non-commutative equations involving other functions than logarithms?
Yes, of course. Yes, we are 2 years ago.
Any other questions? When not, then we thank the speakers. Okay.